What's up guys, I am Waqzite Ahmed Far, Waqzite, and in today's video we will be creating this kind of poster design inside of Photoshop. If you don't want to follow this complete tutorial, you can download the project file or template just by clicking on the link in the video's description. It is absolutely for free. Now let's jump to the video and get started. Okay, so open Photoshop and create new document. Size is 1080 by 1350 and the resolution is 72 pixels per inch. Click on create. Now for the background, let's drag and drop this image into the Photoshop, rotate it and scale it a little bit. Move it to the top just like this. Confirm it and then delete this background layer. Let's create new curves adjustment layer and make the image darker just like this. Now drag and drop this wood texture into the Photoshop, scale it, right click on it and choose perspective, and then distort the layer just like this. Click on this icon when you are happy with the distortion. Right click on the layer and choose blending option. In the layer style menu, click on drop shadow. Make sure the angle is minus 90, and you can also play with the other settings. Hit OK when you are happy. Now create a hue and saturation adjustment layer. Right click on the layer and choose create clipping mask. Now it will only affect the layer beneath it. Decrease the lightness and the saturation a little bit. And now the background is ready. Now drag and drop this image into the Photoshop into a new document. By the way, you can download all of these images from the link in the video description absolutely for free. Pick the quick selection tool and make selection around the burger. Go to edit and choose copy. Switch back to the main document, go to edit and choose paste. Let's rename it burger and convert the layer into a smart object so we can work non-destructively. Press Ctrl T and resize it. Now to create the shadow, let's create new layer and rename it shadow. Pick the brush tool, make sure your foreground color is black and then brush just like this. Select move tool, press Ctrl T to open transform tool and squash it. Also make it a little bit larger and then confirm it. Move this layer beneath the burger layer. Drop down its opacity to 90. Select this layer, create new layer on top of it and select the brush tool. And brush on these areas. To make this area darker, right click on it and choose create clipping mask. Now it will affect only this layer. Now close this document because we don't need it anymore. Drag and drop this image into the Photoshop. Select the crop tool and crop it. Select the quick selection tool and click on select subject. It will select the burger. Now go to edit and choose copy. Switch back to the main document and press Ctrl V to paste the burger right here. Rename it burger and convert it into a smart object. Press Ctrl T and scale it down. Make it smaller from the main burger. Confirm it. Select these layer and put them in a group and rename it burger underscore 01. Select this layer and move it beneath the group. Now to create the shadow, let's create new layer, move it beneath the burger layer and tips one on the canvas. Press Ctrl T and squash it. And then move it right here. Let's rename it shadow. Select this layer and on top of it create new layer. Now brush on these areas just like this. Select all of these layer and put them in a group by pressing Ctrl G. Also rename it small burger. Let's duplicate this group by pressing Ctrl J and then move it to the left side. Open this group, select this layer and delete it. Select the shadow layer and move it to the left. Now create new layer on top of it, select the brush tool and brush on these areas just like before. Now close this document because we don't need it anymore. Drag and drop this fire image into the Photoshop and confirm it. Press Ctrl U to open hue and saturation and decrease its hue to about minus 5 and then hit OK. Change its blend mode to screen and move it beneath these layers. position it right here and then duplicate it by pressing Ctrl J and then move it right here. Now drag and drop this fire image into the Photoshop and resize it. Position it right here. Change its blend mode to screen and then press Ctrl U to open hue and saturation. This time increase its saturation to about 15 and then hit OK. Now select all of these layers and put them in a group and then rename it fires. Let's select the top layer, pick the type tool, click anywhere on the canvas and type something. Confirm it, pick the move tool and align the text into the center. Now let's select this rectangle tool and create a rectangle. Change its fill type from solid color to gradient. Double click on this layer and click here. Click on this slider and change this color to orange color. Also click on this slider and change its color to yellow. Hit OK again. Change its angle to 100 and increase its scale to about 250. And then hit OK. Also move this layer beneath the text layer. Create new layer and select the type tool. Change the color to black. Click on the canvas and type something. This could be anything. Select all of these texts and decrease its size and make it smaller. Confirm it, select the move tool and align it to the center. And you can also add more text according to your mood. When you are done with the text, select all of these layers, put them in a group and rename it text. Right click on it and choose blending option. Move this slider a little bit to the right and then hit OK. Now everything is done, so create new layer. Let's rename it Camera Raw Filter because we will be applying Camera Raw Filter to this layer. Press Ctrl Alt Shift E and convert the layer into a smart object so we can edit its value later if you want. Go to Filter and choose Camera Raw Filter. Follow these settings or you can modify it if you want to. Hit OK when you are happy. And there you have. Thank you so much guys for watching this video. I hope you enjoy it. Hit the like button if you like this video. Subscribe to the channel, also ring the bell icon so you will get notified whenever I post a new video. You can download this project file or template just by clicking on the link in the video's description. It is absolutely free. I will be catch you in my next video. Till then, peace.